Hello, Dave from SparkFun Electronics here. Today we're going to be talking about the SparkFun Hot Air Rework Station. Now, the Hot Air Rework Station is essential for any workbench. It should go right along your soldering iron and oscilloscope or whatever tools you have. Today we're going to be covering actual solder rework. If, let's say, you did a surface mount solder job and, let's say, an IC was rotated 90 degrees or a part is backwards or something went wrong. So we're going to show you how to fix that. It's also really useful for doing things like shrinking heat shrink tubing or even salvaging SMD ICs from other circuit boards that you might not have built. Firstly, with the rework station, I'm going to choose a tip. I'm going to choose this one. This is the slightly larger version of the stock tip that it comes with. I'm just going to push this directly onto the end of the rework station, then use a Phillips screwdriver to tighten it down. This is a nice unit because it has a digital temperature readout. So I have it set right now to about 340 degrees Celsius. That's slightly higher than the melting point of the solder that we're using, but it needs to be because a lot of the heat is going to be dissipated as soon as the air meets the other air of the outside world. And to start with, I'm going to have the airflow somewhere between 4 and 5. It's right around the mid-range. You don't want your airflow too high because then you will have the potential to blow actual parts off the board. It's a good idea to turn it on, wait a few seconds, wait for the light to go off, just so we know the temperature has equalized and we are at the correct temperature setting that we want to be. The kit we're going to be working with today is the surface mount version of our Simon memory game kit. As you can see, I have removed the silicon bit from it and all the standoffs and, you know, mounting hardware. The first thing I'm going to do is mount the board in the alligator clips of my helping hands. The hot air rework station gets very, very hot and it's actually blowing the heat out. So it can actually burn the surface of a table. Helping hands also are a benefit because you can actually rotate the board and flip it over and heat the board evenly on both sides. So now I'm going to double check just to make sure that there's nothing else in the path of the heat gun, because like I said, this thing gets very, very hot and we don't want to set anything on fire. I'm just going to do a nice even heat across the pins of the IC here on the circuit board. If you see any smoke or if the board starts to warp, your heat setting is probably way too high. So turn it off, let it cool down, kind of reevaluate and figure out what the setting should be. In my other hand, I've got these electrostatic sensitive tweezers. And so I'm just nudging the chip a little bit just so I know exactly when all the solder has melted and the IC is free. Now, most integrated circuits are quite heat tolerant. If you look up in the datasheet of the IC that you're trying to rework, most of them have an entry in the datasheet that says the solder temperature, and it will give you some maximum heat value for generally a number of seconds that it can withstand. You can see we've used the hot air station to melt all the solder, and now we have the IC in our hands. So now we can do with this what we will. So this one, I'm actually just going to rotate it here, see if I can get it to line up on the pads again, and just nudge it into place. So some helpful tools to have on the workbench alongside the hot air rework, like I said, are tweezers used for kind of poking and prodding to get the IC to seat properly. It's also very helpful to have something like a flux pen. You can use this and swab the contacts of the IC and it will help the solder to melt and get everything seated into place. Also, when you're done reworking, you need to be sure to wash your boards because there will be a lot of leftover flux, just some kind of gunk. So a nice alcohol kind of prep pad or a Q-tip or something is good for washing the leads of the IC. In addition to doing rework, you can also use the heat gun to shrink heat shrink tubing. I'm going to set the temp a little bit lower than we had it before, and the air, again, about a 5 or so. So I've got two wires here that I've soldered together, and I'm going to just push the heat shrink over the connection. Want it nice and even across the heat shrink tubing there. And just like that, the shrink tube is over the wires. Now that we're done with the rework station, I'm going to go ahead and shut it off. Now you'll notice something peculiar about it. See how it doesn't shut off right away? It's actually still blowing hot air through the system just so it can cool down kind of on its own. Another little trick is if you set the temperature all the way down and the blower all the way up, it'll actually cool down a lot faster. So I hope that was a good overview of the SparkFun rework station and gave you a little bit of insight as to just exactly how you do rework. Word of caution, it can be really easy to mess up. If you have it too hot, if the air is blowing too fast, you can start warping boards, you can fry chips pretty easily. So I highly recommend that you get some scrap boards or, from our ding and dent here at SparkFun, you can get just some practice boards so you can get a feel for just exactly what you're doing. So yeah, I hope this was informative and we'll see you next time with SparkFun Electronics.